Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Nahmaduhu wa nasalli ala rasulihil kareem. So now we're moving on with our emphasis phrase. Now if we have a look, where are we? We said section 1 is words, we've done that. Section 2 sentences, jumla ismiya, jumla fa'liya. Then we've done our phrase in section 3, and the pronouns within section 4. But because this emphasis phrase needed pronouns, we've delayed this until this section. Okay, and in the phrases we have these match in Arab, and these don't match in Arab, and then the first two they match in Arab, and also match in Ding, everything definite indefinite Arab number and gender. Got it? Now, okay, so we have that set up. So we have different phrases: those that match in DING, descriptive and demonstrative. Those that match only in Arab, conjunction, mubdal minhu badal, and mu'akkad and ta'kid. Then we have those that don't match at all, mudaf, mudaf ilay, adadan, shibhul jumla. Now we're moving on a bit, and we said previously the king himself came. How would you say this? The king himself came. Well, ja'al malikul maliku. Before we said, repeat the word. So if you repeat the word, Ja'al Maliku Al-Maliku. Correct? But if we want to, another way of doing that is that we can do that same structure, but we can bring the word nafs. What can we do? We can bring particular words. So when we say Ja'al Maliku Al-Maliku, this is ta'kid wa lafzi wa ma'nawi. Ta'kid lafzi. This is ta'kid lafziyun. Why? Because all we're doing is repeating the lafz. Now what we want to do is create emphasis by using ta'kid ma'nawi. And ta'kid ma'nawi is you use words specifically coined to create emphasis. And two such words are nafs. One word is nafs. So you bring the word nafs with a mudaf ilay. So instead of saying ja'al maliku, repeating it twice, what can we do? Have the word malik. Then after the word malik, bring the word nafs with a mudaf ilay, which refers back to the mu'akkad. So the mu'akkad ta'ki lamzi, what did we do? Just repeat the word. Ja'a ar-rajulu ar-rajulu. Ja'at al-mar'atu al-mar'atu. Yes? But what we can do, and the more common structure is, we bring the mu'akkad, don't repeat it, bring the mu'akkad. Then bring the word nafs, followed by a mudaf ilay, which refers to the mu'akkad. So for example, ar-rajulu nafsahu. So ar-rajul becomes the mu'akkad, the word we're emphasizing, yes? And then nafsuhu becomes the ta'kid. What's this made up of? The word nafs. This is made up of the word nafs. And it's made up of a dhamir, which refers back to ar-rajulu. Do you understand? And now, what will happen? If rajulan is jewel, you bring the plural form, and then you bring the dhamir to match. If it's plural, this becomes plural as well, and that becomes plural to match. If it's al-mar'atu, nafsu, and then you bring ha to match the pronoun. Are you following? So in here, this has the same meaning as ta'ki lafzi, just repeating the word. But it's a more common structure. And you can also use the word ayn. So ayn has many meanings. One is eyes, one is spring. But here it means, again, it's a emphatic pronoun. Just to emphasize that the person doing the action is that person. So for example, ar-rajulu ayinuhu, ar-rajulani ayinuhuma, ar-rijalu ayinuhum, al-mar'atu ayinuha. Hazam, you now refer back to the lady. Al-mar'atan and nisa. Understood? So this is how we use it. So let's try, how do you translate this? On your mic, let's try doing this one. Okay. This is I would translate it as, this is actually the water of Zamzam. You can add the word actually, but obviously in English they said actually is not really need for this word. Grammarians will say, well, this is excess, but we can have this. We can also say what this is Zamzam water itself. So basically we're saying it's not fake. It's not fake, it's actual zamzam. So by saying nafsihi, it emphasizes the zamzam. You understand?
How do tarkib of this?
What's the main slots? Hada is mubtana. Rest is khabar. Made up of? Is ma'u zamzam mu'akkad or zamzam? The mu'akkad. The ta'kid. What's mu'akkad? The zamzam or the ma'u zamzam? Because it's nafsihi. So what does it match in Arab with? The ma' or the zamzam? The zamzam. So ma' it becomes? Mudaf. This becomes the? Mudaf ilay. And zamzam and nafsihi becomes? Mu'akkad. This becomes ta'kid and that becomes? Mudaf, mudaf ilay. Yes? Okay, your turn. J. Yasma is fa'il. Al mu'allimu is fa'il. Al mu'allimu aynuhu is fa'il. And al darasa becomes maf'ul bihi. And translation, and mu'allim becomes? Mu'akkad, and aynuhu becomes the ta'kid. And this is now translated as? The teacher himself listens to the lesson. He doesn't appoint somebody else, or he doesn't say do it between yourselves. He himself listens to the lesson. G, upstairs, G. This becomes the maf'ulun bihi. And then? No, what's the rest include until where? Yeah. Mudaf. Mudafun ilay. And then? Man'ud not. And this becomes? You following? Because the emphasis is on the Imam al-Masjid al-Haram. I saw the Imam of the Masjid al-Haram himself. So the Imam is being emphasized. So we have to make all of this first, Imam al-Masjid al-Haram, then we add the nafsahu. Do you understand? Do you get it? Are you following? So this is the mu'akkad. Okay? Would you go ahead? Yes. So the question is that in the first one here at the top, only this became the mu'akkad, and here the whole thing becomes the mu'akkad. Depends on what you try to emphasize. Here, are we emphasizing the masjid al-haram? Are we emphasizing the masjid? Are we emphasizing the imam? In the second one. So then, the imam is with its mudaf ilay becomes the mu'akkad. And in here, we're not emphasizing water, we're emphasizing the zamzam, that it is zamzam. So it changes depending on what the meaning we're trying to give. So it's not a fixed rule that the mudaf and mudaf ilay become the mu'akkad, or one part becomes, it depends on what you emphasize it. It can change according to what's the purpose of the sentence. Does that make sense? Okay.